I must say I haven't felt so relaxed as I have during the last 4 months or so, for a long time. I have had time to do all sorts of other things. Yeah, I'm doing a lot of reading and walking and observing nature and all that sort of stuff. But I have also kept up my practicing at home. I chose some chorale preludes from Brahms's very last opus, opus 122, which was a set of chorale preludes which were found on his desk after his death, so they were published posthumously. And I chose to play three of these Brahms pieces and their Bach equivalents. Bach also composed chorale preludes on the same melodies. I picked them because I just love these pieces and continue to play them quite regularly in St. Canice's Cathedral after and before services. Two chorale preludes on Schmucke Dich. First of all, the Brahms one, which is in E major, and then Bach's very profound E flat version, which was a great favorite actually with Mendelssohn and Schumann. And Schumann certainly was a great friend of Brahms, so there's a nice link there. Thank you. it is always one of the highlights of my musical year when I play at the Arts Festival. And I've lived so long in the Cathedral Close, so I feel very much it's the home patch, if you like. That doesn't make it any less nerve-wracking, by the way. The other three chorale preludes, one Bach, Herzlich tut mich verlangen, and then two on the same chorale by Brahms. And these are some of the best pieces from the collection of Opus 122.
Thank you.
I was delighted to be able to have a recording on the big organ here in St. Canice's, because actually I've decided to retire after 35 years as organist in this wonderful cathedral. So I hadn't recorded on this organ, and here was a great opportunity.